Shibava song, Shepherd song,
Savior of a song, Lover of a song.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcomers, for the Lord God is on our side. We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We
our most holy Father, we thank you, we bless you, we worship you, we exalt your name. We thank you for you have brought us into a mortal God of never again. Never again shall we shed the tears of sorrow, the tears of we are sorry, the tears of pain, the tears of regret. Rather, it's our mortal God which you will make everything new with for us, O God. Lord Jesus, all that the devil have stolen, God, that we have given out of carelessness, out of pride, whatever. This month, your mercy will bring that back to us, O God, and repair all the wasted years in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, O God, as I stand to minister your word, may I minister your word. Help me, Lord Jesus, and give me the utterance, O God, to speak your word the way you want it to be in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, because Satan has been expelled. All his agents have been expelled. Thank you, Father, because this world will turn our life around to the end. We all will love you more and enter your kingdom on the last day in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Whether we have a message from the Lord, it's a form of reminder of what we already know, just to remind you of what the Lord require of us. And the title of our today's exhortation is Show Your Proof of Your Love for Jesus Christ. Show your proof of love for Christ. The Lord demands that we showcase our love for Him, not just professing it, not just saying it, but it's time to showcase who we are to Jesus Christ. It's time, if you love Him, show it. If you love the Lord Jesus Christ, it's time to manifest our love for Jesus Christ. Not just saying, I am a Christian for months. I love Christ for months. This month, the Lord demands that we all will showcase our genuinity for Him. Showcase our love for Him. Do you love me? Come this side. If you don't love me, go this side. If you are this side and you love me, you must show it to me this month. As I'm making things new with you, you must also make your life new for me and show me how much you love me. Let Satan know that you love me. Let the people know that you love me. Whatever I demand of you, you must do it this month. The Lord is looking for people who will make a difference for Him this month. People who will love Him as never before. And you must showcase it. The Lord will see it. And people will see it. Though people may be saying you are being hypocritical, but Lord knows that you are not hypocrite. Let people know who you are with Christ this month. The Bible told us in John chapter 14, verse 21. John chapter 14, verse 21. He that hath my commandments and keepeth them, it is that loveth me. He that hath my commandments and keep them. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father. I come again, please. He that hath my commandments and keepeth them, it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved by my Father. And I will love him I will manifest myself to him. The Lord wants to make new things in your life. But this can only be prepared. This can only be attracted by your love. You must start your own. He that loveth me shall my father love also. He that hates me shall my father hate also. He that loved me shall my father love, and I will love him too. He that hates me shall my father hate, and I will hate him too. If you love me, keep my commandments. If you love me, do those things that I have commanded to do. I've told you, my children must be perfect the way my father is perfect. If you are perfect as my father, your perfection will draw my father close to you. And wherever my father goes, there will I go. Remember, the Lord says, when he was on earth, say, Father, I know you always hear me, for I do those things that pleases you. Till today, even now that Christ is at the peak of his glory, he's still doing what pleases his father. There is those that my father goes to, that I go to. So the prerequisite of the Lord making things new for you this morning is your love for him. And the payment for that love, the certificate for him to know that you love him, is to keep his commandments. Serve him foolishly this month. Obey him as if you have no other life to live. And really, we have no other life to live. The Bible told us in John 14, verse 15, if you love me, it's not by force. If you say you love me this month, you must do those things that please me. You must keep my commandments. Do you love Jesus Christ? Keep his commandments. Do you love God? You must do those things that please him alone. This month, we must be ready to displease ourselves. We must be ready to displease ourselves to please the Lord. We must be ready to stress ourselves to make the name of the Lord to be stretched all over the world. Praise Master Jesus. The Lord is saying, from January to now, you have been saying, I love you, I love you, I love you. But you are not doing my will. You are not showing it. You are only saying it with your mouth. He said, why calleth me Lord, Lord? Luke 6:46. Why calleth me? Why are you calling me Lord? You are not doing those things which I say. I've told you this is what I want to do. I want you to put those things away and let me be in charge of your life. You are saying no. Yeah, you say, you love me? My daughter, put away all this thing from your body. You say, hey, I love Jesus. But you have ghosts all around you. I want to be the only God in your life. If you love me, my daughter, obey my word. Do away with those ghosts all over your body. Showcase your love of Christ this month. Why call me Lord? Why calling me Lord when you are not obeying me? You are only playing with yourself. You are only endangering your soul. And I pray the Lord will have mercy upon us and give us the grace to obey him in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. If all the Lord is not ready to answer your prayer in your iniquity, don't call him this month if you don't love him. Don't fast and pray this month in your iniquity. Enough is enough. You are betraying stone to heaven if you are praying. Anybody that is praying in iniquity, all you are doing is throwing stone to heaven. This month, if you do it again, all these stones are betrayed, will gather you and throw it back to you. If your prayer must be answered this month, you will be ready to do the will of God. You will be ready to love him and showcase your love for him. My daughter, my son, go for evangelism. Okay, sir. Boom, you are gone. my daughter, my son, no matter how deep the sleep is, get up and pray. You must be ready to get up and pray. My daughter, my son, fast today, you must be ready to do it. Those things, go and do away with them. Your own is to say, yes, I hear you, Lord. You will do it. And I pray the Lord will open our ears to hear him as he's commanding us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. He said to us, don't you know you are saying you love me, but you are not obeying me. It's who you obey that you are loving. Why are you kneeling down before the devil? You are bowing down to the devil. You are coming here to stand before me? No. That one you are bowing down for. That one you are obeying. Just follow him. Let the world know that you are serving the devil. Who you obey is who you are loving. As the Bible told us in Romans 6:16. Knowing not that to whom you yield yourself servant to obey, is servant you are to whom you obey. You don't obey Jesus. You don't obey the word of God, but you are saying, I love God, you love him. When you cannot give a little thing for him, time you don't have for him. We are not praying. We are not studying the word of God. Evangelism, we are not going. We are not. Nothing we are doing. What there is the love for him? What is the certificate of our love for him? Obedience, we are not there. Prayer, we are not there. Fasting, we are not there. Nothing we are doing for him. Let me tell you something. Whenever we disobey Jesus Christ, we are obeying Satan. I pray this month. I say, I want to make this new with you. You will also make your life. I will also make my life new for him. I begin to obey him in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen. Amen.
To whom you obey, you are servant to. Say, servant you are, either of sin unto death or of obedience unto righteousness. The Lord will say, I want to make this new with you. It's not left for you to allow him. If you obey Satan, he will destroy you. That man that come to kill, to steal, to destroy. If you obey him this month, today is the fourth day of the month now. He's telling you this is the prerequisite of my making this new with you. But if you decide to go the other way for that man have none to offer that to kill you. Many people today now say, hey, welcome to new month. As we are talking right now, they step into it, but they are no more. Thousands of thousands will go this month too. We must be ready to obey him so that man that's cutting people off, quiet. There's cutting in his hand. All he's doing is to kill, to steal, and to destroy. He do come to me every day. He do come to you every day. The only reason why he's not able is because of the glory of God around us. We must preserve that glory. How can we preserve it? By allowing the Holy Ghost to be around us. And how can the Holy Ghost be around us? By obeying Jesus Christ. I pray this month, the spirit of obedience will take over us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It's not everyone is saying, I love Jesus. I love Jesus that will enter his kingdom. But only those who do his will. Only those who truly love him with all their heart, with all their soul, with all their mind. No people like Judas Iscariot who are saying, hey, I love Jesus. Why will you waste all these things? Bring for the poor and poor, you don't care about them. You are just eye service. But Jesus Christ knows that you don't love him for anything. You are not obeying him. Many Christians today, if it was those days, by now you'd be a dead person. Many of us are Ananias and Sapphira. You are not doing what you say you will do. But even if you do it, you do it hypocritically. You do it for your own praise, not for the praise of Jesus Christ. I pray this month, the Lord will help me, will help you, so that Satan will not cut us off in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The sword is still there. It's still killing. But he will not be able to kill us in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Matthew 7:21. Not everyone that said unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of God, to the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven. What is the will? To obey Jesus. God the Father have no other will. His will is that the whole world will bow down for Jesus Christ. As it is written in Philippians 2:10, that every knee will bow down to his Son and say, Lord Jesus Christ, you are our Lord and personal Savior. We will obey you. Everybody on this mountain will do so this month in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. This month, as many on this mountain, that their knees are so rigid, their knees does not bend down. The reason why wherever we go, there will be problem is because our knees are not bending. The reason why favor is not there is because our knees are not bending to the level it should bend. Our knee is so stiff. His knee is so flexible to always bow down to Jesus Christ. Anywhere you go, you will stand strong before men. This month, the Lord will give us the grace to always bow down before him, kneel before him, to obey him, and wherever we go, not to hold us on the road in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord is saying today, we have been hearing his word on this mountain. What are we doing with the word? Every morning, word is coming. Every morning, word is coming. We are not like people that crack joke. You just come here, you take it, and you are not doing it. You are still the same. You are your family. You still remain the same. Your heart is still hardened. Say, this month, I'm not ready to entertain people. I'm ready. I want to see people who will hear my word and do them. James 1:22. Be ye doer of the word that you are hearing every day, and not hearer only. Deceive your own selves. Don't take my children as if they are men of thousands of people. The word I put in that spirit is to change you, is to change your family. Not just you hear it and you enjoy it at that moment. You go and your life remains the same. Your life remains the same. You are not changing. This month, today, the spirit is making you to hear the word of God wastefully. I command that spirit to die out of your life in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You know why? Every word we are hearing is being recorded. If, God forbid, you die without doing them. God forbid again. The person enter hell, you will do it there. Everything you hear, you did not obey. You will be forced to obey. That's why I'm always afraid. For people who come to listen to the word of God on this month is being recorded. And I pray the word of God we are hearing here will not be used against us on the last day in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What do we do? Let us be the doer of the word of God we are hearing, and not the hearer only. Let us stop deceiving ourselves. Let us show Jesus Christ this month that we actually love him by doing those things, by living in his fear, by making sure everything we are doing is in accordance to his will concerning us. Let us not do things that is not, let us not go to places that Christ wouldn't go. Let us not carry out action that Christ will not carry out. Let us do everything to please him. At least, let us make him happy this month. At least, let us give back our life for him this month. Let us use everything to appreciate him this month. From January till now, he has protected us. Let us also protect his name. Let us protect his name for him. I pray God help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What do we do? This month, let us marry the word of God. let us mind the word of God as He has told us in Joshua 1, verse 8. It is only by this everything we make new for you. This book of law, the word of God must not depart out of your mouth, but you shall meditate there day and night. Not like that, brother, that person shall be forgiven, that God brought people to. Help me to talk to the people. Instead, you on television for them to start watching the Nigerian film. This book must not depart from you. But you and your family, I and my family must meditate day and night. That we will observe to do according to all that is written. All that is written. For then, only by this shall the Lord Jesus Christ make us prosper and make all this new for us. And we shall have a good success. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
The Bible said, you and I know that all things work together for good to them that love God. That means if you hate God, all things will work against you. That is the word. Romans 8:22. We know that all things work together for good to them that love God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We know that all things work together for good to them that love God and to them who are called according to His purpose. Many people are called according to the purpose of God, but they are not working in that purpose. They are working at the clockwise. God actually brought you out of sin. That through you, people will be brought out of sin. But you yourself, you are advertising your sin to the people. You are advertising your iniquity to people. People who are coming to you, they are running back to the world because of your character, because of your nature. Praise Master Jesus.
Yeah.
I pray God grant us understanding this month to live for Him in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As Samuel told Saul, I'm closing now. The Lord does not delight in your burnt offering or in your sacrifice as in obeying the voice of the Lord. Behold, my son, to obey is better than sacrifice of fools, and to hearken than the fat of ram. 1 Samuel 15, verse 22. Keep your money first. First of all, obey Him. In this ministry, we don't do sacrifice of food here. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We are not like Muslims. Who do sacrifice as if they are, who give out money as if they are doing sacrifice. They call it Sarah, what do you call it?
Yeah.
We don't do that. We give out in accordance to the obedience to the word of God. We don't give our yes to go to hell. No. Listen to the word of God. Digest the word of God. Obey the word of God, and then you can do the sacrifice. I pray God give us understanding in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And the Bible told us in Isaiah chapter 118 and 19. The Lord is inviting you and I to come and die with Him this month. To come and celebrate with Him. Say, come, let those things from January to now, those things that make you to obey me, come and tell me now. Today is the first month. Come and tell me your problem. What is your problem? This simple obedience, why are you not keeping it? Why are you living against your destiny? Whoever that's not obeying the word of God is living against his destiny. My daughter, what is wrong with you? My son, what is wrong with you? How can you enter my kingdom this way? I said, be you holy, for my Father is holy. Why are you not holy? Come, let us read it together now. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Whoever on this mount that is willing and obedient, the Lord said, he shall eat the good of the land.
Amen.
All those things that were difficult for you before, the Lord will make them easy for you this month in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Showcase the proof of your love for Jesus Christ. Showcase the proof of your love for Jesus Christ. Amen.
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 Praise the Lord. Okay, it's Romans 8:28. So sorry, please. It's Romans 8:28. I was error of talking. What I wrote here is Romans 8:28. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So the birth to life is a month of obeying the word of God and showcasing your receipt of obedience. Show it. And people may be laughing, saying you are stupid, you are foolish. With this person, you don't know what you are doing. No problem. But soon and very soon, we will know those that know what they are doing. And the Lord bless word in our hearts in Jesus' name. Amen. Are you here? You are not born again. Come out now. Because your days are numbered. All our days are numbered. But when the number is finished, then we will go to. Say after me, if you want to accept Christ this morning as your Lord and personal Savior. Say, Lord Jesus, I have heard your word. You demand that I showcase my proof of your love for you. But right now, I have no proof to show. But I have never loved you. Rather, I'll be dwelling in the far country of iniquity and sin. But today, I'm coming out. I want to love you. Have mercy upon my soul for hating you ever since. Satan, you made me to hate my Creator. He that died for me. But today you are exposed. I renounce you. I denounce you. I drop all the business I have with you before now. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Come and dwell in me. Take my name away from the book of Satan and write it in your own book, the book of life. I accept you, Lord Jesus Christ, as my Lord and personal Savior. Come into my life and dwell. I go now to sin no more. For I am born again. All things are passed away, and all things have become new. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
I pray with you if you have declared this declaration. Father, I give you all the praise and thank you for this once God. Your word have healed these souls. Father, Satan, I've just lost these souls now. I pray that with your grace and power, guide them in this narrow road, O God, to heaven, to your kingdom, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, the road they pass through as we're coming, block it so that they will never be able to go back to that road again when they remember cooking back or whatever they were eating over there, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Father, this word will not be used against me on the last day, but will be used, O God, to prepare me and everyone ahead it to your kingdom, in the name of Jesus Christ. Give us the power and the grace, O God, to showcase our love for you. Let nothing be too difficult for us to give us for you this month, O God. Father, help us, O God, to be flexible. Every spirit of wrath that will make us to be too strong to bear for you, that spirit, kill it out of us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yes,
Father. Thank you, Jesus. Because Satan, we know that we actually love you this month. So we always obey you. Promptly, in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.